मंचस्थ श्रद्धेय संतवृंद, उपस्थित अन्य सभी मान्यवर, सभागृह में उपस्थित सभी सुधी श्रोतागण, बंधु भगिनी माता, आई एम टोल्ड टू स्पीक इन इंग्लिश. आई आस्क द रीजन, दे सेड दैट people will be more comfortable with English. I am uncomfortable because it is not the language of my practice, and secondly he has asked me to create history within some minutes, span of some minutes, that too in English. Anyway, kesari, this word became popular in our Bharat first when Lokmanya Tilak started the kesari. And here is our Malayalam kesari. There is a little difference of depiction. That kesari had no words. Here there are two words, Swayameva Mrugendrata. I heard that Pujaniya Guruji at that time had come here and had a very good press conference here, wherein all doubts about Sangha were cleared. The program was impressive as well as effective, but reporting was zero. Next day newspapers did not carry a single word about it. And then one of the then editors of one of the papers, he was asked by our Shankar Shastri ji, why didn't you report, none of you reported the event. So he said that, okay, your function was very nice, but our policy doesn't allow us to publish it. So truth needs some permissions to be published. That was the situation, and that is why kesari started in ghor upeksha. There was nothing was available for kesari, no prasiddhi, no professional expertise, no financial backing, no support of any power. Parmeshwaran ji wrote, I think, the maiden editorial of this. And I also heard that Shankar Rao Shastri was editor, manager, as well as the distributor of this. Even distributing, manually distributing the paper also. So the sole reason that kesari has completed 17 years and now has its own, I should say, it is a palatial building. Our sangha standards, they say that this is a palatial building, so they have that sort of building. This 70 years journey was not a journey of comfort. The Swayameva Mrugendrata, that was the Shraddha. We don't need any recognition. If we have right, we are right and we have truth. One day, this is the country of Satyameva Jayate. People will recognize, Kalo hi ayam niravadhir vipula cha prithvi, like that. And for that there was continuous effort, very hard labor, and there was quality. Dr. Hidgavar also used to have a baton in his hand, our old Ganvesh, was nearly the military Ganesh. So there was, for officers, two things were different from other Swayamsevaks. They used to have that feta, safa, shirovesh. And another thing, they will have that baton, military baton. And on the handle, on the grip of that baton, it was carved, this carving of lion and the words Swayameva Mrugendrata. Dr. Ji also had on his letterhead a Sanskrit line as the heading. That was Kriya Siddhis Sattva Bhavati Matam Nopakarane. You can accomplish anything if you have that metal. The upakaranas, the accessories, they are secondary things. Behind your resolve and behind your sincere efforts, these things come automatically. So that has happened. That was going to happen, and now that has happened. But the thing is that in the joy of all these things, we get very delighted when some such instance. Now today also, this is an event of our happiness. We have accomplished something. Now we have got a solid footing. Shankar Rao Shastri Ji, Raghavan Ji, I think no one is there to witness. Entirely new generation is. So this new generation must remember how this happened. What has happened is giving us joy. It is very good. We wish more such occasions in the future of Kesari. But for that to happen, Kesari today must remember Kesari yesterday. These amenities, these conveniences, they were not available then. And they are not the instrument of your victory, of your success. They are there and they are to be used, nothing more. They are not obligatory. Whole thing runs on your own resolve, your faith in your own cause, your faith in victory of truth. In spite of total darkness before your eyes, there is nobody to help. There is nothing to help. And everybody is ready to pin you down always. Still, if we have truth, we can win. That faith must be there. I will strive so that truth will win. I will strive for the victory of truth. That resolve must be there. And actual efforts should be put in. Then everything happens. Guide in my college days, he used to tell me, our professor, that real scientists do not complain about their laboratories. Edison had no laboratory. He used to tell us that. So we don't have this facility, we don't have that. If you have will, and if you are prepared to exert, then everything comes your way automatically. And today's event is a glowing example of that. For 70 years, we strived with a particular goal in mind. And now we have attained the stage, but goal is still away. Kesari is a product of certain thought. A long tapasya is going on in Bharatvarsha. That tapasya, that penance is necessary for the upliftment of Bharat. and upliftment of Bharat is necessary for emancipation of today's world. Especially last 6 or 7 months, we all can perceive that world has started rethinking. We in Sangha and many others who knew the wealth of thought in Bharat, they used to say always that something is wrong, world has to rethink. But no one used to give much value of these statements. The corona situation, what happened I don't know exactly. No one can analyze it fully, but world has started rethinking. And this rethinking of things leads every nation invariably to Bharat. Bharat has to give answer. And to give that answer, Bharat has to understand what we are. Swayam eva mrigendrata. What am I? Who is that Swayam? What is that Swa? That is the important thing. Even Gandhiji had said that many people are now demanding Swaraj. But I am doubtful whether they understand what is Swaraj. And then he said that you cannot understand the meaning of Swaraj unless you are very well conversant with your Swadharma. You must understand Swadharma. Then only you can understand what is Swaraj. He said, my patriotism, my Swaraj is firmly rooted in my Swadharma. In my religion, he used the word religion. He said, it is not a religion restricted to a particular worship. It has its own worships, but it is a religion of religions. That is Bharat. And for the education of Indian people in that particular subject of Swa, there are many working, right from times of Vivekananda in modern times, that educating our people, that effort is a continuous effort, going for eons. But its new edition in modern times, suited to the modern times, started with Vivekananda. And that effort is going on. That effort was viewed with something alien. No, this is not good. This is bad. This has to be thrown out. We must have something new. We must cut ourselves from our past. That is not useful in modern world. Already all these ideas, they were ruling the minds of Indians. Why that came to pass, there is history. But in this era also, this effort was going on continuously with the faith in truth. Truth will prevail. And now it seems that time has come, truth has prevailed, and on the basis of that truth, many things will have to be reconstructed, many things will have to be repaired, many things will have to be adapted and adjusted inside. And a new way of life, social, political, economical, in our world, as well as in the world outside, in Bharat, as well as in universe, the way of Dharma has to be established. Kesari started for that Dharma. Kesari has to work for that Dharma. They diligently work for that Dharma, Dharmo Rakshati Rakshita. So we came to have our own building, But this work is not yet over. With the same diligence, with the same attitude of expecting nothing from outside, but to be able to connect with everything that comes, everybody who contributes, and carry them forward along with us on the path of Dharma. It is the same way, we have to continue in the same way, we have to strive hard, because the things have changed, the outside situation has changed, now we have got a bhavan, we have got so many things, we cannot allow ourselves to relax. I think whenever we get to attend any such occasion anywhere, wherein there is an accomplishment, at the result of that we get something, some new convenience, some new building, some new vehicle, some victory. In that joy, we must not forget. In 8th class, we had a lesson in English text. There was a king, and king had a minister. Minister was very popular with people as well as the king, because he was a wise man. But as it goes in politics, when there is one successful person, there are 10 who don't want him to be successful. So there were some such persons in the court of the king. So they started watching that fellow, watching the minister. What can we point out in his character or is in his working style? Anywhere, some fault, so that we can tell the king to some things that will take the king away from that minister. And they found one thing. They went to the king and told, "You are believing in that our minister, but he is not a good fellow. He is conspiring against you. Daily he goes out of this city, out of the castle, through a secret way in the jungle. And there, in a very old house, he does something. We don't know, we have not yet investigated, but we are sure he is so secretive, it must be against you. He is taking undue advantage of your faith in him." So king decided to verify. And one night he followed that minister, came out of the home in the midnight and started towards that secret way. King followed him. He went into jungle and he entered that house, oldish house. King also followed. But when king entered the house, he was coming out. So king caught him and scolded him. "I believed in you. I thought you were sincere, but you are a traitor. Without my knowledge, you are doing some conspiracy here." He said, "No, sir, no conspiracy. I come here and I visit the room. What is in that room?" He said, "Come, I will show you." So they went into the centralmost room of that house. There was a large cabinet, old cabinet. He opened that cabinet and showed a old torn coat to the king. He said, I look at this daily and then I come back." "So what is this? What is there in this coat?" He said, "When I came here as a beggar in this city, now I am minister, but I started as a beggar. And on my own, I am a self-made man. I achieved these things. But when I came here, I had only this property. This is how I started. I must not forget. This is how I started. And these are the pains through which I traveled. And now I am successful. Now I am an achiever. Achievement is nothing. Tapasya is the main thing. Achievements come and go. There are hard days and there are easy days. But the thing that drives us, that takes us along safely through all sorts of days, that is the important thing. So everything else is told by very experienced persons like Hariji, our Swamiji. You have got some suggestions also, as I could understand from Malayalam. So there was nothing left for me to tell you. And I must tell you, I must tell you something so that I can justify my presence here. That is why I thought that I should just take you back from the starting point and ask you to remember this journey, not only today, forever, so that we have got a very good means through which will carry us through every thick and thin situation of life and make us not only successful, make us meaningful, because we achieve successes for the goal. To be successful is not that easy, but yes, there are successful persons. World doesn't remember all successful persons. Only those successful persons are remembered who have been meaningfully successful. Those who collected wealth, the list is very long and nobody remembers it. But Bhama Shah everybody knows, because he gave all his wealth for the effort of freedom to Rana Pratap. 8,000 years from the what historians tell us today, Ramayana happened 8,000 years back. But Ram is remembered. From Ram to now, today's Bharat, there were so many kings. Everybody is not remembered. Ram is remembered even after 8,000 years. Because he gave away his kingdom for the sake of Vachanapurti, and then he ruled his kingdom for the sake of people. So their successes were hard won. Their successes were extremely laudable, but their successes were meaningful. That meaningfulness we have, that is why we have thrived in spite of all odds and we have won. But that meaningfulness must last till we achieve our goal. I think that much power of memory God will give you to achieve that goal, because that is also a satya goal, that is a dharma, and satya, dharma, they are ultimately victorious everywhere. That is our faith. So congratulations, you have achieved something. Finish this building. There are some finishing touches have to be given. Finish them early and utilize the building for the furtherment of our ideal and our goal. Thank you very much.